Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genci. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can set up the beams and the joists in one of the floors of this project. So on level 16, first I'm going to create some beams, and I'm going to consider them aligned with the grids number 1, 2, 3, and so on. So let's go to the beams. If you don't have any beams in your project, you need to go to load family, and you need to go to structural framings, and the concrete is here. I already opened the concrete rectangular beam, so I want to go with this value. Yeah, if you want to go with a different value, you can go to edit type and duplicate and create a new one. That's something you need to discuss with your structural engineer. So I want to create a beam from here to here on grid number 1, and if I go here, you see that actually there is a little bit of overlap between the beam and the floor. So I actually need to move the floor as much as the depth of the floor. So in this case, if the floor is 150 millimeters, I want to assign an offset of 0.15. So it's going to move up. Now there are no conflicts. And I want to hide it for now using HH temporarily. So we can only focus on the structure. And here, let me make sure that I select the floor and I hide it here too, so you can see the beams. So this is the beam. I want to copy that a few times to have it also on my grids number 2, 3, 4. On grid number 5, the beam is going to be from here to here at the top and from here to here at the bottom. And I have a different plan for this span 5 to 6. I'm going to consider the main beams on this direction here, and the joists are going to be like this, and it's going to be cantilevered to fill this area. So I'm going to have two beams over here. Also, I have two more beams over here, so I'm going to have some joists being cantilevered to this side to fill this area. I have one more beam over here. So this is the beam system. Now I want to continue with the joist. I want to go to the beam system. I want to select a different beam type. I want to go with 300 by 600. The joists do not need to be as big as the beams, and you can create a different beam with a different size and assign it here if that's what you wish for. So I'll go with this one. First, I'm gonna get the boundary line. We can start by picking supports. This is one support here, one over here, and one over here. And I want to complete this to be a closed loop by selecting the pick lines. So I want to select the interior side of the wall, this side as well, and I want to pick this line. Okay, and let me hit tab. This line is gonna give me the exterior side of the floor over here and over here. Actually, let me pick it again. It's gonna be here. Now make sure you have one closed loop, so you need to use trim. Otherwise not gonna work. So this is my boundary here. As I mentioned, the direction of the joists are gonna be different over there and over here. So I just need to assign the direction. The direction is gonna be a very short line here just to show that the beams are going to be horizontal. And finally, I want to adjust this fixed spacing. So I have four spans here. I want to consider three smaller spans in each of them. So it's going to add up to 12, right? You see, I have this value here, 24.4. If I divide 24.4 by 12, it's going to be 2.03. So I want to round that up. And to the fixed spacing, I want to assign 2.04. Now I know I'm going to have three smaller values or spans on each of these bigger spans. So let's do this. It all looks good to me. I want to finish edit mode. And now you see that we have the beams here, and this is exactly what I wanted. It's going to be cantilevered here to fill this part of the floor. For this part here, I want to create another beam system. It's going to be sketch. I want to select this support, this one, and I want to finish it over here and over here. Make sure to trim the edges. And I need to assign the beam direction, which is going to be vertical here. So the joists are going to be cantilevered around here. So this seems good. I want to check the box. I have the beam over there. That seems good. I want to select the beam system and make sure to hit tab when you want to select the beam system. It's going to show these dashed lines. And I want to actually mirror it over here. So we're going to have it on the other side as well. So this is how the beam system is going to look like in this project, and the floor is going to be on top of it.